Hello, my name is William Akers, and I'm the trombone teacher at Brass Belt Music Store. Today I just wanted to make a quick video demonstrating how to clean your trombone. I would say you might want to give your instrument a full at-home cleaning about once a month, and it's actually a fairly simple process that includes three big steps. First, you'll want to disassemble your instrument and place it in a full instrument bath. Second, you'll carefully remove the instrument's parts and floss the tubing. And then third, you'll reassemble and prepare the instrument so it is playing ready. So let's first take a look at disassembling the instrument and placing it in the bath. As a reminder, with disassembly, the bath, and then removing the instrument's parts, we want to be very careful so we don't accidentally dent or scratch the pieces. As you can see, I've taken my trombone apart completely. You can see two slides, the inner and outer slides, the bell section, and the tuning slides. A standard student model trombone will only have one tuning slide, but my instrument has a trigger attachment that requires a second tuning slide. You can leave the mouthpiece out of the bath since we'll take care of its cleaning later in the video. Now, the bath that the instrument is placed in is just two parts. The first part is you'll need to fill the tub with lukewarm water, not too hot and not too cold, but just comfortably warm to touch. And the second part is basic dish soap. The warm water and dish soap gently break down any buildup inside the tubing. Now we'll let the instrument sit in the bath for 20 to 30 minutes. If you'd like to be extra careful, you can also place a towel down inside the tub so that your instrument lays on top of a soft towel instead of the bottom of the tub. After about 30 minutes, I now take the parts out of the tub and I like to lay them out so that they drip dry for maybe 10 more minutes before I take them back to the practice room for the rest of the cleaning. Again, always remember to hold the bigger pieces like the inner and outer slides, as well as the bell section with two hands. Now that we're back in the practice room, I can finish the rest of the cleaning process. At this point, I always make sure I have a trombone snake, mouthpiece cleaning wand, some paper towel, and preferably a soft microfiber cloth. I first use the snake to floss out the tubing. One major thing to note here is to be careful not to push the snake down too deep in the outer slide. We don't want to push the snake around the crook at the end of the slide, because there's a chance the snake will get stuck. In between each of these, I like to just wipe off any material that comes out of the tubing. Then I like to use the microfiber cloth to gently wipe off the inner slide. And then I floss out the mouthpiece with the wand and some warm water. And finally, we can begin reassembling the instrument. I first start with the bell section. Before putting the tuning slides back into the bell, I make sure to take a small amount of slide grease with lanolin and apply it to the tuning slides. A well-greased tuning slide will make it that much easier for us to adjust at the beginning of rehearsal. I then put the bell section down and pick up the inner slide, applying slide lubricant. Here I like to use the Yamaha brand product. And I carefully put back together the inner and outer slides. A side note about the trombone slide. You can take a small spray bottle with water and spray the slide to reactivate the lubricant after having the horn put away for a day or two. Now that the two big pieces are all back together and our mouthpiece is clean, I can put everything back together now and I'm all ready to play. Thank you for checking out this video and happy practicing.